10 days from now is the one-year anniversary when Russia brutally, illegally, and in a completely unprovoked way invaded the sovereign nation of Ukraine. As the Secretary just pointed out, Putin thought he could defeat Ukraine quickly, fracture the NATO alliance, and act with impunity. He was wrong. Ukraine remains free. They remain independent. NATO and this coalition has never been stronger, and Russia is now a global pariah, and the world remains inspired by Ukrainian bravery and resilience. In short, Russia has lost. They've lost strategically, operationally, and tactically, and they are paying an enormous price on the battlefield. But until Putin ends his war of choice, the international community will continue to support Ukraine with the equipment and capabilities it needs to defend itself. Through this group, we are collectively supporting Ukraine's ability to defend its territory, protect its citizens, and liberate their occupied areas. In the face of a barbaric Russian invasion, Ukrainians remain resilient. The nation of Ukraine is united for one single purpose: to expel the Russian forces from their territory and to defend themselves. For Ukraine, this is not a war of aggression. It is a war of defense. For Russia, it is a war of aggression. The Russian military has paid tremendous costs in their war of aggression, and now they have resorted to sending conscripts and prisoners to imminent death. In recent months, the group who gather here today pledged to provide significant quantities of battlefield capabilities, tanks, air defense, and munitions. 11 countries have pledged tanks, 22 have pledged infantry fighting vehicles, 16 pledged artillery and munitions, and 9 more pledged air defense artillery. The group is focused on delivering the capabilities committed and efficiently providing the training, the spare parts, the sustainment, logistics necessary for the full employment of these systems. Training, maintaining, and sustaining Ukraine's remains key for Ukraine to prevail. Throughout this war, Ukraine has showed incredible resourcefulness in how they integrate varied capabilities to adapt to the changing dynamics of this battlefield. Ukrainians have combined unbreakable will with innovative tactics and empowered their leaders to liberate their own country. Russia, in contrast, is waging a very costly war of attrition, while Ukraine is effectively leveraging their asymmetric advantages in order to defend itself. And the most important asymmetric advantage they have is courage, resilience, and tactical skill. This war is extremely dynamic, and Ukraine today is fighting while training and evolving for future operations. Ukraine will integrate recent commitments of armored vehicles, infantry fighting vehicles, and tanks with fires to achieve the effect of synchronized ground maneuver. While Russia has waged this war for far too long, they will not outlast the Ukrainian people nor the group of allies and partners that met today. The purpose for the United States and allies, as said by our political leadership, is very simple. It's to uphold the rules-based international order, an order that rejects the idea that big, strong, powerful nations can attack other smaller countries, that borders shall not change just by the use of aggressive military force. This is the very underlying founding principle of the United Nations at the end of World War II. Ukraine does not stand alone. 54 countries met today to ensure that Ukraine can defend itself and the principles that guide international conduct, and those principles will be upheld. We will remain a unified coalition. We will continue to uphold the values of sovereignty and freedom, and we'll continue to support Ukraine.